I thank and praise God for this time. Let's sing this song. This is one of my favorite songs. Majesty.
Praise the Lord. Greetings to all of you in the sweet name of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I thank the Almighty for giving me this opportunity today to share my testimony over here. And I do want to thank Deborah Rice Moment for giving me the opportunity today to share my testimony. My name is A. Hepzibah Sondaram. I was born and brought up in a Christian spiritual family, and my hometown is in Pondicherry. God gave me a wonderful parents, and I am the only daughter to my parents. I was brought up with all spiritual and biblical principles, memorizing Bible verses, singing songs, worshipping, and involving in church ministries was the entertainment all that I did in my childhood days. Besides my studies, there was no extracurricular activities for me other than ministry and singing songs, worshipping God, music and children ministry and things like that. I was so involved in God's work in my childhood itself. There was a specific anointing over me that I used to pray a lot in my childhood days. I used to pray for us together. I received the baptism of the Holy Spirit when I was studying class 2. When I was too young, I received the baptism of the Holy Spirit in an all-night prayer. And when I was 12 years old, I received the baptism. What a baptism! I gave my life to the Lord. I made a covenant. Lord, I will follow you till my last breath. I confessed all my sins and I admitted that day, that very day, I am a sinner and I need forgiveness and I want Jesus Christ to be the master of my life. Then I took water baptism when I was 12 years old. My dad was a pastor, so he was pastoring a church, doing ministry along with him, going for house visiting and going for castles, taking part in church ministry, children ministry, youth ministry. I like to do all those things when I was a child and in my youth days too. Gradually, when I started growing up, I had a lot of dreams as well. I wanted to become a doctor. I wanted to, whomever I see, I wanted to become like them. That was it. That was my dream in my young age. But God in His good plan, I could say, Jeremiah chapter 29 verse 11 says like this, "For I know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and future." Yes, my dear friend, it was so true in my life. Although I had different plans for my life, although I carried different dreams in my life, but God had a specific plan in store for me, and He made it possible in His time. When I was studying class 10, one good day, one early morning, I got a vision from God. I saw Jesus in front of me. He came in front of me, called my name, Hephzibah. He called my name. Whenever I testify this, I could feel the presence of God overwhelming me. He called me by name and He told me, "Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord is upon you. For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth, and deep darkness the people, but the Lord will arise over you, and His glory will be seen upon you." Third verse was the specific call for me. "The Gentiles shall come to your light, and the kings to the brightness of your rising." Isaiah chapter 16 verse 1-3. God spoke to me. He called me for His service, for His kingdom service, for my master's service. I received the call of God when I was studying class 10. I surrendered my life to the Lord then and there. I gave my life to the Lord for His service. I committed myself, "Lord, I will serve you wherever you take me. Whatever you want me to do, I will do for you. Just give me the strength. Just enable me. Just encourage me, O Lord." I gave my life to the Lord then and there. Then I did my diploma in theology in Tengasi in Trinity Bible College. God trained me over there. He equipped me over there. He broke me. He made a new vessel out of me. Then I did my class 11 and class 12. Then I went to do my high theological studies, Bachelor of Theology in Calcutta. Over here, when I came to North India, when I was studying in North India, I received a special burden to serve among North Indians, to serve North Indians. I used to always tell, "I love North Indians. I want to speak Hindi." I had the deep desire in my heart, my dear friend. That desire only took me forward till this date. I always used to pray, "Lord, I want to serve in North India. Please make a way for that." When I finished my theological studies in the year of 2015, in God's good plan, I got married in the year of 2016, the very next year, to a North Indian pastor. He is from Bihar. I got married in the year of 2016, and my husband's name is Aditya Arya. He is from Bihar. Since then, myself and my husband, we are serving the Lord in His vineyard. For the very purpose that God has called me to do, we are doing it. Although troubles came. Problems came. Many times we wanted to quit and go back. But God strengthened us. God enabled us. As the verse says, one who is called is faithful. Even though you walk through the waters, He is with you. Even though you walk through the fires, He is with you. My dear friend, He will never leave you nor forsake you. I have tasted it in every step of my life. In every ups and downs, I have tasted the love of God and the faithfulness of God. Whatever is written in His word, it is true, my dear friend. Anyone can forsake you and everyone can forsake you. But the Lord who is carrying you in the palms of His hand, He is telling us, you are the apple of my eye. Yes, it is so true. Just as the apple of His eye, He took care of me in every ups and downs in the mission field here. Lot of health issues. I faced climatic problem, extreme hot and extreme cold. It was too difficult for my body to adapt to the climate. But God is helping me. Still I am struggling, but God is helping me. I face a lot of health issues, homesickness. And sometimes, to whom you are serving, they don't understand. Lot of emotional stress, mental stress. But through it all, my Jesus, my Savior was faithful to me. Just because, you know, I was obedient to the call of God. As Psalmist says, obedience is better than sacrifice. Yes, it is true. Obedience is better than sacrifice. God is not expecting anything from us other than obedience. He wants us to obey like Abraham. How he obeyed. He didn't question God. Just like that, I didn't question Him. Not out of ignorance, but that was installed within me to obey God. I saw my dad and mom obeying Jesus, obeying God's word, giving priority to God's word, God's kingdom in their every step of their life. They set up a good example before me. They are living an exemplary life before me. Every step of my life, every step I take, I'm always careful. Lord, I should be in the center of your will. I don't want riches. I don't want name. I don't want fame. I just want to be safe and secure in the center of your will alone. Even if I have to go through several struggles and persecution, Lord, strengthen me to go through it if that is your will. Even last month, my husband, myself, my in-laws, we all were down with COVID. That 15 days, we do not know how it went through. Can you imagine? Everyone in the family is down with COVID. Who will cook? There is no one to take care of anyone. Each one has to take care of their own self. In that kind of situation, God gave His love within each other. God helped us to recover from COVID. God is helping us to stand for Him, to serve Him. Even through this testimony, my dear friend, I just want to encourage each one of you who is hearing my testimony through this video. My dear friend, always make sure that you are in the center of God's will. If you are in the center of God's will, you are safe. The enemy can never attack you. It may seem like the enemy is touching you, but above all, the hand of God is upon us. Even to test Job, the enemy had to take permission from the Lord. Without permission, Satan cannot touch you and me. If God is permitting, then that is fine. We have to accept it. We can't question God. God, you know my situation. You know my financial condition. Then why did you allow this? No, I can't question such a way. I had to accept it because that's the will of God. I had to go through it. Because His promises are so true. Even I go through fire, He is with me. He is not leaving me alone. Your mother and father can forsake you, but the Lord who shed His blood for you will never leave you nor forsake you. Every single day, God is so faithful to me. Many a times I fail to love Him the way that He is loving me. I fail to be faithful to Him the way He is faithful to me. But God is so gracious enough over my life. Just as my name, Hephzibah, He is delighted over me in everything I do. Just He is asking me, obey my word. And as the Bible verse says, He who began the good work within me is faithful enough to finish it well. Yes, my dear friend, all I pray today is, God, make me popular, make me a big pastor, make me a big preacher. I don't pray such way. Rather, I pray, Lord, help me to run this race faithfully. Just like Paul, at the end of the day, I too want to say, I have fought a good fight. The crown of righteousness is kept for me. The end of the day, what I have in this world is not the treasure I carry. When I take my last breath, what I did for my Savior, what I did for the one who has shed His blood for me, that matters a lot. If I am faithful to Him, I will have the satisfaction when I die. Do not store up treasures in this world. It will be destroyed. But store up treasures in heaven. Then no one can destroy it. And God will honor each one who is serving for His kingdom. I count it as a great privilege and honor to serve God in this very young age. I am too young, but God has taught me so many things. God was faithful to me all throughout my life. From the day I was born, I do not know, but when I was in the mother's womb only, God chose me for His work, for His service. He led my entire life according to that. And all that I did was just, I learned to be sensitive to the voice of God. That's all. I learned to be sensitive to the voice of God, and I started developing the thirst within me to serve Jesus. And the same Savior is leading me and leading my family, leading the ministry till day. He is faithful all the time. May each of you who is listening to this testimony, my prayer is for each of you today, is may we learn to listen to the voice of God. May we learn to be sensitive to the voice of God and always understand that obedience is better than sacrifice. Let us obey God without questioning. Let us have faith in Him without questioning, without having any doubt. He will be always faithful in every step that you take. May God bless each of us. through this testimony. Continue to pray for the ministry. Continue to pray for myself and my family. Always. Thank you.
In Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, formed through the fiercest craft and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are still, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. In Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe. This love of Christ and righteousness, scorned by the ones he aimed to save, till on the cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid, here in the death of Christ I live. No guilt in life, no fear in death, this is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny. No power of hell, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his hand till he returns.